Hi, I'm Ramasiran from ECE department. Welcome to talk on design of reduced feedback scheme, user scheduling and MAC protocol for full-duplex communication systems. This is the outline of the talk. First, I consider full-duplex cellular system. Here, I propose a reduced feedback scheme for inter-user channels and a user pair scheduling and mode selection algorithm. Then I move to full-duplex wireless and local area networks. Here I propose a protocol called asymmetric full duplex medium access control protocol. Then I finally conclude the talk. Full duplex is one of the candidate technologies considered for next generation wireless communication system. It enables simultaneous transmission and reception of signals over the same bandwidth. Full duplex is expected to be implemented only on advanced transceivers such as base station and access points in WLAN. Due to its hardware complexity and cost involved. Here we have asymmetric full duplex cellular system with the full duplex capable base station and half duplex users. The base station can receive signal from a uplink user while it is transmitting to another downlink user. This is in contrast to half duplex, where either uplink communication happens or downlink communication happens at a time, but not both simultaneously. The simultaneous uplink and downlink can double the spectral efficiency of the cellular system compared to half duplex system. However, the spectral efficiency gain comes with new challenges. First is self-interference at the base station. This is due to proximity of uplink transmitting, downlink transmitting antenna and uplink receiving antenna. Second is interference between uplink users and downlink users due to simultaneous transmission. Third is four-channel interference from neighboring cells. Focus of this talk is inter-user interference. Controlling inter-user interference is role of user pair scheduling and mode selection algorithm. In user pair scheduling, the base station selects a pair of uplink and downlink users with weak inter-user interference between them so that uplink and downlink SINRs are high. In certain scenarios, it can be shown that full duplex mode is more gives less spectral efficiency compared to half duplex mode. In such scenarios, the base station switches to half duplex mode depending on feasibility. This is called mode selection. User pair scheduling and mode selection happen at the base station based on estimated uplink and downlink SINR. Here we have expression of downlink SINR. When uplink user is U and downlink user is V, numerator is received power at user D. The base station can estimate the value of this using reciprocity principles. Denominator is the sum of inter-user interference and co-channel interference and noise power at user D. The base station can know this value of co-channel interference and noise power using traditional feedback mechanisms used in half duplex cellular system. However, the base station cannot estimate value of inter-user interference. That is because these inter-user interference links are not connected to the base station. Therefore, the users need to feedback these values to the base station. In a cell with n users, there are total n choose to inter-user interfering links. So this number grows as order n squared. This constitutes enormous feedback overhead on the users. Therefore, we propose a reduced feedback scheme and a user pair scheduling and mode selection algorithm for full duplex cellular system. In the proposed reduced feedback scheme, the base station selects a user, so user F. The criteria for selection is discussed in coming slide. The selected user feeds back a set containing a lowest interference value and corresponding user indices that are below a threshold called gamma threshold. Here we have taken example of L equal to 3. Here users 1, 2, and 3 cause three lowest interferences to user F, and these values are below threshold. These are the user F feeds back values of these interferences and corresponding indices 1, 2, and 3. Also, we can note that even user 4 has low interference to user F, that is below threshold, but it's not included in the set. This threshold value is system parameter and it needs to be numerically optimized, and interferences are quantized. Next, we propose user pair scheduling and mode selection algorithm. This algorithm is a three-step algorithm. In the first step, the base station selects a user, say user F, that maximizes uplink and downlink SINR. If maximum value of SINR comes from uplink SINR, then the scheduled user is scheduled in the uplink, else it is scheduled on the downlink. Here we have expressions of uplink SINR and downlink SINR. When uplink user is U and downlink user is D, we can note that the base station can compute value of uplink SINR using available information itself, and it cannot compute value of downlink SINR. That is because it doesn't know value of inter-user interference between users U and D. So it uses following value, where inter-user interference is replaced with a threshold value. Therefore it can compute value of downlink SINR now. Also note that this value of this downlink SINR is always less than actual downlink SINR when uplink user is U and downlink user is D. Then the scheduled user feeds back to set containing a lowest inter-user interferences to the base station. Now the base station has to select second user for the reverse link. From the feedback indices, it can compute value of some spectral efficiency when first user is F, and for all the pair of users F and the users present in the set. So it schedules second user, maximizing some spectral efficiency. If first scheduled user is uplink user, then the base station selects downlink user from feedback set. If first user is downlink user, and then the base station schedules second user on the uplink. The base station selects hard duplex mode in following situation. If feedback set is empty, or the hard duplex mode gives better spectral efficiency compared to full duplex mode. Here we have plotted some spectral efficiency versus number of users in the set, users in the cell. Here we have plotted for proposed algorithm and two algorithms that are available in literature. It is AKA1 and AKA2. We consider special case of feedback called index-only feedback, where users feedback only indices of the interfering users, but not channel gain. We can see that the proposed user pair scheduling and mode selection algorithm gives better spectral efficiency compared to AKA1 and AKA2. Also, it gives better spectral efficiency compared to half duplex system. Next, we consider full duplex WLAN. Here, we propose medium access control protocol called asymmetric full duplex MAC protocol. We consider following system model. Here, AP is full duplex capable and users are half duplex. The AP is connected to all the users, but users need not to be connected to all users. Some of the users are hidden to particular users. For example, 7 is connected to only user 2, but it is not, all rest users are hidden from it. The proposed asymmetric full duplex MAC protocol selects first user, that is called primary user, based on CSMA-CA based channel contention mechanism. And then AP schedules secondary user to exploit FT on the reverse link. It introduces two management packets to enable full duplex in WLAN. Here we have three scenarios based on winner of first channel contention. If user is a winner of backup process, then the user sends RTS packet to the AP, and AP schedules another user and starts transmitting to AP in parallel. If AP is a winner, it starts transmitting packet to a user, and parallelly it informs another user to transmit to it in parallel. In In another scenario, if API and users backup counters expire simultaneously, in that scenario, if API's destination node is hidden from the user whose backup counter is expired, then both can communicate parallelly. Here we have plotted saturation throughput of proposed protocol versus number of users in the cell. These are topology average results. In each topology, two users are connected with probability 1 minus PH, and they are hidden from each other with probability PH. We have plotted a proposed protocol and different variants of proposed ASD MAC protocol to compare the protocols available in the literature. Also, we have plotted saturation throughput of 802.11 protocol. We can see that the proposed protocol outperforms all the protocols, including 802.11 MAC protocol. This improves throughput to twice that can be achieved with 802.11 protocol, depending on number of hidden nodes. Following are the conclusion, we saw that full duplex is promising technology to improve spectral efficiency in next generation wireless communication systems. Enabling full duplex in cellular or WLANs has two challenges. First is controlling inter-user interference and modifying CSMA CA protocol to allow simultaneous transmission. Reap performance improvements in full duplex. The cellular resource allocation and wireless local area network MAC protocols need to be redesigned.